Shouldn't that be in a field somewhere?
Oh, that. Oh, that was Margaret. She found it in the caravan. Something like a morbid mascot for what happened there 2 years ago.
Why? What happened 2 years ago?
I wasn't going to tell you.
Tell me what?
All right. Don't get hysterical, okay? But a couple of years ago, there was some murders on this farm.
Murders?
I don't know what to say. Do you not watch the news?
Do I look like someone who watches the news?
No, I guess not.
So when were you going to tell me? Halfway through the season?
I was hoping it wasn't going to come up.
Yeah, so you signed us up to work on this murder farm.
I didn't sign us up. You found this place. And we need the jobs, we need the money.
Yeah, but there's working risks and then there's working on murder farm type of risks.
It was 2 years ago.
Yes, and Ted Bundy was 50 years ago and people are still talking about him.
It was a long time ago, all right?
So who was it?
Who was what?
The killer.
I don't know. I don't know.
What else did they say on the news? Did they get them?
I don't know.
They still might be around killing people.
Well, we're in the middle of nowhere, right? And I'm sure if there was a killer running around, they wouldn't be opening this place in the next 2 weeks, would they?
That's exactly what they want you to believe. You don't know these people. I've only met Tina once.
And I've met both of them. And yeah, they're a handful, but they're trying to move on.
And what did they say about the murders?
I didn't ask them.
You didn't ask them?
No, I didn't think it was appropriate. One of the victims was Tina's daughter. And over there, that's where it's said that, well, they burnt him alive in there.
Jesus. This just gets worse and worse.
Look, you've got nothing to worry about, all right? Would it make you feel any better if you knew the details?
Well, what fucking difference is gonna make it now? There's no signal here.
Tina did say she was gonna get Wi-Fi down here. But until then, you can get a reception down the road.
What difference does it make it now? Does it?
Wait. Where are you going?
I'm going down the road to get some signals. I can see what else you're not fucking telling me.
What? On your own?
Not anymore.
They're coming to get you, man.
Oh my God, stop it. It's not actually funny.
It is funny, though. Okay, you're getting worked up over nothing.
Over nothing. There's psychopaths running around killing kids, and you're saying it's nothing.
Well, you've got me to protect you.
How many fights have you been in?
Well, if you know, I've been in quite a few.
And how many have you won?
I'm still there, aren't I?
So, if I come up to you with a knife, you would know exactly what you need to do.
What, a maniac with a knife? Absolutely. You with a knife. I'll be as good as dead.
You're such a simpleton.
for me to start over?
What exactly did you mean?
Look, it's safe here, alright? I'm in the middle of nowhere. No neighbours for miles. And definitely no more killers, alright?
I'm not staying here.
Well, where do you want to stay?
Nearby town, Airbnb.
No, because we're just going to waste all our money on a hotel when we can stay here for free.
I don't want to be another story on the news.
Oh, come on, alright? Let's finish the lights, yeah? Then we'll go back to the lodge. I'll do a sweep and lock the doors.
How safe is this?
It's safe, alright? We've been here for 3 nights. No one's been killed. And Tina and Mary, they stay on the farm. Do you really think they'd stay here if it weren't safe?
Okay. Yeah? I still don't like it though.
I know. All right, let's turn these babies on.
Okay.
You wait here, okay? You let me know if they come on.
No. Look, you can't just leave me here after all the shit you just told me.
It's all right, all right. Okay, I'm only going around the corner, yeah? You know how to turn the lights on, all right?
Oh my God, Rob!
How does it look?
It looks great! Come and have a look! Rob? Don't be a dick. Rob. Rob, I swear to God, if this is where you're gonna jump out and scare me, Rob, if this is one of your jokes, Robert. If you seriously think you're getting late tonight, you better pack this. Are you just gonna stare there or gonna do something about it? Otherwise, I'll have to find someone else on that campground to please me. Okay, cut this out. I had enough. Oh, shit. Okay.
We were waiting for you.
I was just doing a recon of the place to see what still needs attention. Come on. Where's Maya and Robert?
You haven't seen them since yesterday.
What the f*** are you doing? Get away from there.
It's just a scarecrow.
Take it down now.
Whoa, okay.
Just take it down before my mother sees.
Jeez, it's not hurting anyone.
I don't care. I want it gone. Do you not know what happened here? There's a tragedy here. And that thing, it's just a bad omen.
Sorry, Harriet.
Just get rid of it, burn it. I just don't want to ever see that thing again.
You gonna help me? You okay?
Yeah.
Sorry, I had to see. Two priests and three psychics.
Not one of them has felt anything evil.
It's safe here now.
Did you hear from Robert and Meyer?
No, I tried calling them, but there was no answer. And one of the girls told me there was a bit of a party planned, so you might want to make a note to look into that.
Do you think they found out? About Lester?
Tina, let's not go there.
I just don't like the thought of everyone running off scared when they find out what happened here.
It's over. We killed him.
I know. No one will believe it anyway.
It's over, though.
Even though they didn't find a body? I mean, the greatest trick the devil ever pulled was convincing the world that he didn't exist.
Oh, Tina, let's not go there.
But this place has to be cleansed.
Two weeks.
It'll be good. I mean, I know Mom didn't want this place opened up to the public, but we need to do something before the council try and reclaim the land. It's been a trying couple of years, and there isn't much inheritance left on my side.
I still can't believe Derek let his life insurance policy lapse.
Typical men. You can't rely on them for anything important. They can't even die properly.
To run, so
I'll go and see if I can find Robert and Meyer.
She said get rid of it. Is this going to be okay?
Don't worry about it. We'll get rid of it once we get around to cleaning out this caravan. This one looks like a bugger to clean. This can be one of yours to do.
Seem worse.
Settle then.
Hi everyone. Okay, so I want you all to be on your toes. Heads held high and attentive. And smiles! This isn't going to be any ordinary glamping spot. This is going to be the best glamping location in the whole of the country. We want to attract attention of investors from all over the world. Once word spreads, this place will be on the map. You will all be the faces of Amityville Farm Glamping, okay? Every guest is a priority. and every request has to be heeded. I have faith in each one of you. Please don't let me down. We have 2 weeks to get this place in ship shape, okay? I'll be on point on all aspects, but I want each of you to take ownership of anything that you're doing. We're a family, and I want each of you to see this place as yours as well. Any questions? No? Okay, well, let's get to it. And no more practical jokes, okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go. Hey, is anyone in here?
Oh, Dylan,
what the f*** are you doing?
Sarah, why are you so jumpy?
I'm not jumpy, you're the one sneaking around when you should be working.
Look, I was just trying to have a bit of fun. You didn't have to attack me.
Believe me, it could have been a lot worse. Why are you even up here? I don't need this. Stressed enough as it is.
I'm sorry.
Why are you even in here? This is Mum and Auntie Tina's office.
Sorry, I didn't realise. I just thought I could help.
With what?
With, like, bills and stuff.
That's not your job. Your job is the grounds.
Yeah, but I did all these financial things. I did a year of accountancy, remember?
Dylan, Mum and Auntie Tina deal with all that.
Hey, Harriet. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. It's just...
Because of what happened before?
No, I mean... Yeah, kind of. It's just a lot for me to get around, that's all.
I'm not sure it's such a good idea to open so soon after everything that's happened.
Yeah, it needs to be. My grandmother had the best intentions for this place. And if we lose it, who knows what might happen. At least this way we can have some control over it.
You just sound like your mum and your aunt talking, not you.
I guess.
You never told me your side of things anyway.
And I never will. Mom, look, it's nothing to do with you, okay? It's just, I really don't want to relive that night. And anyway, you might think I'm crazy.
Come on, Harriet. You go a little mad sometimes.
Hey, I'm not mad.
Well, at least you're not the one talking to psychics.
No, I just think that they get a little bit of comfort from it, that's all. You know, knowing that this place is just finally clear of all evil.
I do think you should talk to
someone. Oh, I'm fine, Dylan.
I know you're fine. I'm here if you ever need to talk, okay?
Okay, thank you.
So does anyone know what happened here 2 years ago?
No.
So this place is cursed?
Well, that's nothing new. This place is called Amityville after.
Yeah, but the Amityville house claimed that the brothers shot down their entire family because they heard voices in their head. Then the locals burnt the house down because anyone that went in there apparently heard voices telling them to kill them all. And then the kids' summer camp opened.
So then what happened?
So, there's this guy called Lester, and he worked on these grounds, like on the site. And he was a favourite of all the kids. They all loved him. Until one summer, these kids just went missing. One by one, they just turn up dead on the cornfields. Turns out Lester did it. He spent too long being exposed to the evil that radiated from the earth. He heard voices in his head telling him he had to make a human sacrifice. Then the kids' summer camp never opened again. Until, about 2 years ago, a family came here. They wanted to reclaim and expand. But when the Amityville house got burnt down, the souls got trapped inside, they'd seek refuge in anyone or anything that was nearby. So this family that came here, they got murdered right here on this site where we're sitting. They were terrorized, tortured. They were cut open like pigs in line at a slaughterhouse.
Christ.
That's not even it. There's some survivors, but they swore never to tell the tale.
Then how do you know about it then?
Some of it's public knowledge. Look it up if you don't believe me. But these survivors that walked away, apparently they disposed of the killer. They said it was Lester who'd returned to finish what he started. But then he just vanished. No one knows what happened to him. Rumor has it that he's still here now. He stalks this site. He's just waiting for fresh victims. Then he awakens, bloodthirsty, ready to attack anyone that enters his territory.
What happened to the survivors?
That's the crazy part. They're here now, turning this place into a glamping site.
Bull.
It's not bull. Tina's daughter and husband died here. Ask her if you don't believe me.
Well, that's enough dirty talk for one night. Come on, Simon. What's going?
But I want to hear this.
There's some real dirty talk for you in the tent.
Poor guy.
That wasn't true, was it?
100%. Right. Who's going to help me finish this?
Here with you. I'm here with you. There's nobody else.
I don't believe you. I saw you looking at her today.
What do you want me to do? Do you want to blind myself so I don't look at anybody else?
Don't talk to me like that. You know, you really know how to make someone feel like shit.
Yeah, and you make me out to be shit. When is this gonna end?
I'm gonna get a shower. I feel dirty.
Walk away. Let me take all the responsibility. Again.
Hello? Is someone there? Brennan? Don't just stand there, Simon.
Babe?
Give me my towel back.
Beth, is that you? Babe, you still in there? Look, I know I say some dumb.
She's probably still sleeping. Reckon she made Simon do an all-nighter.
She sensed the tension between them two.
I did. They need to chill.
Yeah, but Margot didn't make it any easier for her. He couldn't take his eyes off her.
Yeah, but Beth needs to chill. Men love. It's in their nature.
It works both ways.
True.
Well, I'm sure she'll come when she's ready. I just hope she pulls away because I'm not picking up her slack all summer. Not to mention now, there's loads of jobs to be done because Maya and Rob just sailed like that.
Probably got spooked when he heard what happened here.
Well, it's enough to make me rethink staying here.
Get these out.
Mad. Like Margot was telling the truth.
Says here they never found him. He was suspected but never tried.
When's that from?
Date of the article says 30th September 1981.
So that'd mean he was well into his, 70s by now?
So Margot was telling the truth. That means everything else she said was also true.
Why would somebody want to keep these?
Are you two awake? Hello? Okay, I'm coming in.
I know. It's a lot to take in.
I don't understand how this place can still be open.
It was a long time.
But surely people need to know, isn't there some health and safety around this?
You know what? It's not as if it's still ongoing. This matter is resolved.
I know, but...
We have gone to great lengths to make sure that this place is safe. I know what you're saying. How could we be so callous? But I assure you that we are the polar opposite of that. We wouldn't have brought you here if it wasn't safe, and we certainly wouldn't be opening it up to the public if there was any reason not to. I'm sorry I didn't tell you. But this isn't something that we want to remember, let alone talk about. This place has seen some really... But it's over now. That's why we need to clear out all the old stuff. It can't continue to live in infamy. What this place needs is a fresh start. We need this to be a success, to show that we can recover from adversity, grow as a community, and change the past as we see it, not focus on what happened. And we need you, Lily. You. And people like you. Strong people with morals and dignity. Ready to stand up for what they believe in, willing to do what it takes. I want you to be proud of what we accomplish here. We need each other. You need to trust me.
I think we should have left them. Maybe yes, it's coming.
You guys, you're right.
Hi. Mm-hmm. Where have you been?
Just went to town to check my messages, get some supplies.
You know that shit you said last night? We thought it was an urban legend. Turns out it's true. We found proof. Old newspapers about child murderers.
Yeah, no, it's true. I read it a few years ago. It's worse than I remember, though.
It really is.
Yeah, but they've burnt him alive, so don't worry about it.
Yeah, but it said they found no body. Are you sure they didn't just torch him?
No, they locked him in his work shed and burnt it down with him inside.
Do you think it was in the shed we saw earlier? I don't know. It was a bit charred, but it definitely wasn't burnt down. Still standing.
Yeah, probably the evil inside keeping it from going up entirely.
I bet they built a new shed on top of the old one. That's like the worst place to put a new shed, on top of an old torture chamber.
That's why Harriet said it was off limits.
Mm. It's off limits? Oh, that just makes me want to go in even more now.
I don't know.
Oh, come on, we can go tonight. We'll just leave everything as it is.
I don't
know. Oh, come on. Don't be a couple of... Don't you want to see what's inside?
Simon and Beth have left.
They just up and left? Without saying anything?
I guess. They didn't show up for work this morning and the suitcases are gone.
I don't like this.
I feel like it isn't over.
It has to be over.
I've got this niggling at the back of my mind that something isn't right. Maybe we're the ones that are cursed, not the land.
Don't talk.
I can't help it. First Robert and Meyer, now Simon and Beth.
There's no evidence to suggest that they're dead. They just didn't show up to work.
That doesn't sound strange to you? Four people just up and vanished, no communication since.
Yes, it's extremely strange. But when you've seen the kind of things we have, anything out of the ordinary is either not obvious enough or suspicious as hell.
I don't know what to do. Have we put the lives of everyone in danger?
I don't think so.
I just can't seem to shake this feeling that something bad is going to happen. Is happening.
We need to focus. When this place is up and running, then this feeling will recede. When the camp is full of people and we're preoccupied with taking care of everyone, things will get better. You'll see.
I hope you're right. don't know what to do in the meantime to take my mind off things.
Come on, let's get you out of this stuffy room and into the fresh air.
Okay. Thank you.
That's okay.
No. I mean it. Thank you. For everything.
We're sisters.
I don't like this. Beth and Simon gone, Lamite and Robert. I envy them. Sometimes I just get this overwhelming feeling that I just need to get away, but I'm fucking stuck here.
For who? Your mum?
I can't leave them. Something just doesn't feel right.
I don't need you. This place is cursed. Nothing can change that. If we leave, we can be rid of all this.
I really need to tell you about what happened.
I'm listening.
We came here to make things right. To try and move on with our lives. You know what my family are like now, but they were a lot worse back then. I don't even know where to start.
Start at the beginning.
Darker than I thought it would be.
Yeah, we're in the country, there's no street lights.
Yeah, I know. It's pitch black out here.
I need it up the balls for this.
Oh, shut up, Margot, I'm here, aren't I?
I don't think I can do this, girls.
Come back out now, we're already here.
It's not right, we shouldn't be doing this.
Fine, go. Me and Cindy will go inside. Go! I'm not gonna back out to you.
Let's just get this over with. Wait. Yeah. Shed's unlocked.
I need to go tell my mum that I'm leaving.
Is that really what you want?
Yeah, it is. Time I went my own way, away from all of this. I love my mum and my aunt, but I can't do this anymore, Dylan. Just every day being reminded of what I've lost. I just can't do it anymore.
If you're sure.
Yeah, I am. But I need you to help me.
I'll be here for you. Whatever you need.
It's filthy in here. When was the last time they cleaned?
No, but the door was unlocked, so someone's been in here. I know they're hiding something in here.
Let's just find what you're looking for and go. I don't want to be here any longer than I have to be.
Just keep your eyes open.
I'm leaving.
I heard what you said, but you can't leave.
I can't stay here. I can feel my skin crawling. I get nightmares.
We all do, but you belong here.
Why? Because I'm related to you.
You and Mom took on this responsibility, not me. I don't want this place to define me. I want my own life.
Have you spoken to your mom about this?
No. She's blinkered when it comes to this place. She won't listen. There's too much history here and it's just too much hurt.
So you want me to tell her?
Please. She'll listen to you.
This is all very sudden.
It's not. I've been thinking about it for a while. I didn't know how to bring it up. Look, this just isn't my legacy.
I didn't want this to be my legacy either. But it's part of me now, my responsibility.
Just let them have it. They can flatten it or build something on the land.
I can't. You know I can't.
Well, you can't. But I can. I need to leave.
I understand. I just don't know how I'm gonna tell your mom. We'll talk about this later. Okay.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. What's going on?
I don't know how to say this. It's Cindy and Margot. They've gone to the workshed.
Oh, why? I specifically told them not to go in there. She's so irresponsible.
I'm sorry. It's not your fault.
Do you know why she went in there?
Yeah. They think you're hiding something in there. I told them not to go messing around where they're not wanted.
That's okay. Thank you for telling me. We need to go get them.
I'm sure they're fine.
Before they hurt themselves.
There's nothing in there to find.
I hope you're right. Come on. On. Slowly. What happened? Where's Cindy?
They killed Cindy!
What? Is this some kind of joke?
No, it's not a joke. It was like a scarecrow or something.
A scarecrow?
Yeah.
Oh my god. I knew it wasn't over. Back, Mary. We can't hide from this any longer. Lester.
The paedophile guy from the newspaper.
No, he's been in like his 70s now.
He's back. You can't deny it.
Where's Dylan? 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 I'm trying to clean up this blood. Oh my god, where's Dylan?
It's okay.
Where is he?
It's okay. It's okay.
Why is the blood? Where is he?
We'll find him.
Why is he not here?
Why was the blood?
We'll find him.
What if he's not here?
Let's go.
What if we need to get out of here, okay?
You're okay.
What do we do now?
Dead.
Oh, of course it is. This is how it starts. Phone's dead. Can't call for help. There's a madman in a mask killing everyone.
This isn't helping, Margot. Harriet, you, Margot, and Lily, go to end of the road. Call the police.
No. I've got to find Dylan.
We'll find him. When you get to the end of the road, you've called the police. Just keep going.
We can't run away from this. This is our home. This isn't my home. Come on, Harriet, we've got to go.
But we have to stick together.
We need to finish this. We'll let Harriet and the others go.
She's my daughter.
Which is why we're letting her go. She can't be a part of this. She needs to live her own life, not be a victim of ours. You and I are tied to this place. I don't want to see her waste away on this campsite. It's not her fight.
Is this what you want, honey?
I'm sorry, Mom.
It's okay. I just didn't know you felt this way. I understand.
I didn't know how to tell you. But I can't leave. You need my help and I've got to find Dylan.
No, Tina's right. This isn't your battle. We've done this before and we'll do it again. Go.
Are you sure?
Yes, go.
I love you, Mum. I love you, Tina.
Come on, let's go.
Just stay together. Okay, just hurry.
We'll find Dylan. Go!
I'm so frightened, Tina. It's okay. It's okay. I won't let anything happen to you. Come on.
Hi, yes, police, please. I need to report a murder. Someone's killed my friend. Oh, no, this is serious. No, please, just send someone right away. I'm at the Amityville Farm campsite. Please, just hurry. I don't think they believe me, but they'll send in someone.
Oh, God. Wait, can we go now?
No, I've got to go back.
We're not going back.
Oh, I'm not just sitting here. My mother's over there.
You didn't see what I saw, Harriet.
Believe me, I've seen worse.
Oh, come on, girls. I'm sorry, Harriet. I don't want to die out here.
You're not going to die out here.
You don't know that. Look, we can just go. We can keep driving. The police can sort it out.
I'm not waiting around for the police, Margot.
I'll wait for the police then.
What, on your own?
Sage, have you got a plan?
I'm in. Okay, come on, let's go. Goes to the front and one of us goes to the back. Okay, one of us can be a distraction while the other one gets the better of it.
No, wait, I don't like that plan, so who's going to be on their own?
I'll go around the back.
No, wait.
Just follow the plan.
No, wait, I don't have a weapon or anything.
It's a workshed. Just grab anything you can with some weight to it. Tina, please come on, wake up, wake up. Mum, come on, it's Eric, come on, wake up. We need to go, Mum, come on. Please, wake up.
We need to get out of here. about you.
Dylan, what the f*** are you doing?
Oh my God. Did you kill all of those people?
They all deserved it.
What is wrong with you?
Well, right now, is this thing sticking out of my back.
I loved you. I trusted you. I thought you loved me.
You're a nobody, and you're gonna rot in jail for the rest of your life.
Oh, I'm not a nobody. You don't recognize who I am, Tina. You clueless. You really don't recognize who I am, do you? I'm Lester's grandson.
No.
Feel him the night you burned him alive. Hear his screams, feel his pain, his anguish. But most of all, his hatred for you. When he died, whatever lived in him came and it found me. And that's when they started. Quiet at first, like a whisper over my shoulder. But day by day, they grew louder and louder, and I realized what I had to do.
No, no, Dylan, no.
No. No. No. No. No.
We need to go. It's Dylan.
What happened to Dylan?
No, it's Dylan. The scarecrow is Dylan. Dylan is Lester's grandson.
What?
There's no time. We need to go now.
I've got you all right where I want you.
Go. Oh.
Why is the sign here?
I just took it down. We need to get rid of the name on its curb. I'm just sick of looking at it every day, just being reminded of what happened.
Names aren't cursed. They can carry a legacy.
And what legacy does the name Amityville carry?
Well, we can think about changing the name. Let's leave the sign for now and just have a talk.
I don't want this place to be muddy by the past. You know, just being known as that murder campsite.
What happened in the past happened, and we can't change it. What we can do is focus on the future. If you decide to stay, we can do whatever it takes to make things right for you and the baby.
No, I'm not leaving. And when Aunt Tina gets out of the hospital, be a proper family.
Let's have some tea.
Okay. Mum, was that you?
Was what me, hun?
Nothing. Never mind.